the car show, and I realize I'm starting to feel pebbles through my shoe. What's going on? Let's take a look. Can these shoes be saved?
These are my car show walking around shoes, inexpensive Dockers. Just when they're broken in and have a nice patina, the soles disappear. The best thing I can do is take them to my friend Gene. He's my go-to guy for shoe repair.
Okay. Hey, Gene, I brought these shoes in. The tops are beautiful. There's a nice patina, but there's no bottoms on them anymore.
Okay.
Can these shoes be saved?
Yes, they can.
What do we have to do?
Well, I'll have to cut off the old sole and then put a new sole on for you. So we can do that. Change the whole bottom, the heel and the sole. So we can do that. That's not a problem at all.
Okay.
So in order to do that, I'm going to have to cut most of this off instead of grinding it on the machine there, only because it's easier. So I'm just going to cut what I can without damaging the shoe. And I'm going to cut it down to a level where there's not much to sand on the machine. So you have to do this, otherwise you're going to make too much in the way of dust to try to sand or grind this all out. So I kind of have to do that, but you have to do it somewhat carefully so you get a lot of the old sole and the heel. And this is kind of a softer rubber, so it's not so difficult to get off. And if you've got a sharp knife, that's not a big project. Well, my father was working downtown for a number of years since he came to this country after the war, World War II. And he worked in the city of Chicago, a number of shoe repair stores. And then somebody told him and gave him the idea, why are you working so hard and making money for other people when you can own your own business? So my father got to think about it, and he thought he could own his own business, but he didn't really have all the money. He didn't have all the money to actually buy a business. And when this store in 1962 was for sale, my father checked it out, but he needed some financing, getting some money. So he went to the supplier that he knew that supplies us with the leather and rubber, and the man there, the owner, gave my dad a loan and paid the man back a little bit each month, and my dad bought the business then in June 1st of 62. So we've been here for 53 years. My father worked hard to establish the business because the man that had it, he was retiring, so he kind of let the business go down. My father kept working long hours to establish the business, and he felt good about it. And then I would use, my brother and I both helped my father at times on Saturdays and vacation times. And then I helped my father because business was very, very, very good back in the late 60s. So I started after high school working for him when I was 18, 1969 full time. And I'm still doing it now, and it's 2015. So 31 and 15 is 46 years I've been doing this full-time myself. And my father worked here for 40 years from 62 until 02. Then his health failed him, and then he passed away in beginning of 05. So I've been here running the business by myself since that time. So I've been here 10, 11 years running the business. And at times business was a little lean, but after the downturn in the American economy in 2008, business started to pick up because people were trying to save money somehow. And one thing led to another. And so the business from 2008, 2009 has picked up because many people didn't know, instead of throwing shoes away, that they could get them repaired. And we've been busy ever since. So we'll do backpacks, purses, things that we can do. If we can do it successfully, we'll do it. But I don't like to take on too many things because my shop isn't all that big. And I don't like to take on too many projects. I will if I have the time and it's not too involved. But at the same time, people might think, well, you can do this and you can do that. And that's true. But first and foremost, I'm a shoe repairer, so I've got to take care of shoes. I can't be sewing up tents or whatever and leave shoes here and not work on them either, because that's my bread and butter. That's what we're here for, is fixing shoes. But if I can fix something, no matter what it is, I'll try to help the person. And if I can't fix it, if it's too involved or whatever, and I don't have the resources, I just will tell them I can't do it. So they might find someone else that can. But it's been pretty good. So now I got the second shoe just about all cut down the way I had the first one. This is called the finisher. It's got different grades of sandpaper, a trimmer to get a fine edge on soles and heels. And then the last part will be your brushes, black and brown, and a burnishing wheel to put this edge on the edge of a sole or a heel. This is a sole I'm going to put on because it's kind of a lightweight sole, and it's not heavy, and it's a long-wearing, durable sole. And being that it's a more of a casual shoe, it still has a grip to it, but it's not so pronounced that it looks like a work boot either. But I'll have to now grind the rest of this down so that I can, after that's all flattened like this is, I'll be able to be in a position to glue that together, and then the new sole will be on the shoe itself. So I sanded it, and now it's kind of
kind of leveled off and smoothed off, so that should be able to hold a new sole on. And then we'll trim it up and finish it on the finisher.
Fantastic.
That's it.
Okay.